Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we are going to be creating a command block timer or stopwatch, whichever way you want to look at it. And I looked online for quite a while to find a video that explained this clearly in a way that I understood. I didn't find anything that was perfect, so I'm going to create this for you guys today. If you like this video, please do like it and subscribe to the channel so you can see all future updates. But without any further ado, let's dive in and look at how we create command block timer. Right, so first thing I need to do is give myself a command block, like so. Then I need a few other things in my inventory. I need a redstone block for a little bit later on, and a lever as well, but that should be it. So first things first, I need to create an objective in my scoreboard. And the scoreboard will keep track of objectives and players for me, but at the minute it doesn't have any objectives or players. So let's place down a command block. Now, take a careful look at the arrow on top of this. When you place a command block, that arrow will point towards you, and you need to make sure that the signal is passing along in the direction of those arrows. So if you're putting a few command blocks down in order today, make sure that number one is pointing towards number two, and so on. Right, let's right-click this, and as I said, we're going to add an objective. So we're going to type / scoreboard objectives add time dummy time. And what this does, it adds an objective called time. The type of objective is a dummy, as in we can't affect it by in-game actions like dying or collecting an item. It's affected by commands. And finally, this second time we've typed time, this is the display name. So this is the name of the objective, and this is the name when it's displayed. For us, they are the same. Okay. Now, all the commands from today's lessons are going to be in the description of the video. And if you want to copy and paste them into your worlds, that's absolutely fine. So next, we need to control how our objectives from our scoreboards are displayed. So we're going to put down a chain command block that is always active. And we are going to type / scoreboard objectives set display sidebar time. So this takes our objectives called time and it sets the display to the sidebar. Very simple, okay, but essential because objectives can run in the background. So if you want to actually see them, you need to run this command and you need to put here where you would like to see them. So we want to see this one in the sidebar. I'm going to do the job. We'll close that one there. Now, this next command block, our third one in a row here, chain, always active, and we're going to create a player for our scoreboard. So we've got an objective, which is displayed at the top. We want a player and a score. So as you can see from this diagram here, it's quite labeled up in a way that looks like a timer. But actually, what we're dealing with is an objective and a player and a score that goes up by 1 per second. So we need to think of it more like that rather than creating a timer, really. So we want to create that player. So / scoreboard players add seconds time 0. So what's going on here is we've added a player called seconds. So we haven't actually got seconds that are being added. We've just got a player called seconds and their score is going to go up. So we've added a player called seconds to the objective time. So we have to put the objective here because there can be more than one objective. So we have to label it clearly. And then we've set the score of that objective for that player to 0. So before we go placing a load more command blocks, we want to test that these three work. So we're going to shift click here and pull that down. And as you can see, we have our objective, our player, and our score set up there on the right hand side of the screen. Perfect. Now let's move on. Over here, we're going to put another command block, and this one is going to increase that score by 1 every time it's activated. So for now, we'll leave this the same, but we want to do / scoreboard players add seconds seconds. Yep. Time one. Scoreboard players add seconds time one. So we're going to add a score for this player in this objective of one by every time. All right. So again, let's not have to go back and fault find. Let's shift click a lever on there and test that it works. So whenever I push the lever down, it adds one to that score. It doesn't do it by itself every second, but we've tested it and it works. So let's get rid of that lever and look at how we can automate this. And it isn't too tricky. We're going to right-click on the block. We're going to change it from an impulse to a repeating block. So it's going to keep adding that one every time. And we want to change the delay in ticks to 20, because 20 ticks is equivalent to 1 second. And the last thing we want to do here is uncheck this. So we don't want it to execute straight away. We want it to wait 1 second before it adds a time on there. And that should do the job. Again, let's test that it works. Let's put a redstone block next to it and watch that time go up by 1 second. Now, there's a few problems with this. First of all, on the left side of the screen here, we've got all of our commands popping up, so we don't want that. And also, we had to put in our redstone block ourselves. And what we really want is we want to be able to push this lever. We want to have the redstone block appear over here, and we want to get rid of all those command block outputs on the left-hand side of the screen there. So that's the next couple of things we're going to do here. So let's add in on this first run of command blocks a chain block that is always active. And first of all, we'll put that redstone block at the coordinates where it just was. Now I've made a note of my coordinates. So I'm just going to write setblock /setblock. Then I'm going to type the coordinates. Now, it will be different for you, of course. So you need to make a note of your coordinates. But my coordinates over there are 21, 64, 9006. And I need to type the type of block that I want, redstone_block. So /setblock21649006, redstone_block. So that all looks fine. It should do the job. And then finally, we want to stop all of those command blocks outputs appearing in the sidebar, the other sidebar, the left sidebar. So nice, simple one, /gamerule command block output false. I'm going to check that that's spelled correctly, because any little mistakes, of course, and it will not work. Game rule, command block output false. And that's going to stop all of those things displaying in the left-hand side of the screen there. So if I flick this lever down, we should get a block appear there, and our seconds should start counting up from 17, because that's where they were left at. So there's our block. Seconds are going up by 18. And every time a second goes up, it is not displaying on the left-hand side, which is exactly what we want. So we'll leave that going up. Final thing we need to do before I think we move on from this one is going to be a reset button. So we're going to get rid of this block and get rid of the objectives. So first command block down here, it's just two command blocks, this one. We'll leave this as an impulse block. We'll leave everything the same, and we will we will get rid of the objectives. So we'll do /scoreboard objectives remove time. And the good thing about this one is when you remove the objective, it removes the player and it removes the score. Okay, so it's a nice simple way to just clear everything away. So we just remove that objective. And you'll notice that my time is still going. So what I need to do is let's have a look at this one. Yeah, I want to control middle click this command block, because it will save me a bit of time, and pop it down here. And I just want to change redstone block to air. So it just gets rid of that redstone block and replaces it with a block of nothing, just air. And this one before, it will also just shift click a lever on there, get rid of the objective. So I'll put that down. Objective's gone. And that's turned back to air. So let's test this out. Lever down, time in seconds pops up, starts counting up from zero. Pop this lever down, and it gets rid of it all. You can obviously use buttons, work fine as well. Levers work, levers do the job. You could put a sign or a slate above here, kind of a chalkboard, just explaining what each one does. Now, obviously, there's a lot more stuff that scoreboards can do. It's quite complicated, or it can be, and I think that was enough for this one lesson, just to look at how to get a very simple timer up there. But I will go into more depth on this in future lessons, so please make sure you subscribe up to the channel, have a look back through all of our other how-to videos, instructional videos and lessons, so you see them coming out. But until next time, have a good one.